When revival comes to the church will never be the same again. When I look back at my ministry at Cross Church in Northwest Arkansas, I remember a definitive day, I remember a moment, and I remember some secondary moments and successive moments that followed that literally redirected that church. And we call that day the day revival came to our church. And in reality, I really believe it was there. It was genuine. We were living in the moment where the power of the Holy Spirit was being outpoured from heaven. And I saw open repentance. I saw immediate obedience. I saw in brokenness like I've never seen before. And since that day, on June the 4th, 1995, that church has never been the same again. When you look back at the real results of revival, it's not simply about a moment. It was what I would call a generational moment. Just recently, when I left as the senior pastor of that church, that day was recounted by so many people to me in personal conversations because it so, in their words, altered their life forever. That's what revival does. Revival is when the presence of God comes upon God's people and they experience life like they've never experienced before. Yes, they were followers of Christ, and yes, they were trying to walk with the Lord, but when God's presence and power comes upon a church, upon a life in a sovereign way, and when that church or that individual is so willing to embrace what God is doing, when those two come together, there's nothing like it. That is the need of the church today. Because immediately, it was no longer about what's good for me, how is it going to affect me? It became, how are we going to reach our community? How are we going to take the gospel to Arkansas? How are we going to take the gospel to America? How are we going to take the gospel to the world? And that was a moment when the Great Commission began to live in and through and around us more than ever before. That's the power of revival, and that's what the churches in America need today.